Hello, little champs. How are you? I hope you are fit and fine. Your maths educator, Shraddha Vaghani, is here again. Today, we are just going to revise our first chapter. You already have your revision worksheet with you. So come along. We will solve together.
In our first chapter, large numbers, we saw place value system, successor and predecessor, rounding off of the number, and then we saw comparing of numbers, and then was ascending and descending order, and the last topic was Roman numerals. Let's have a look in detail. The first topic was place value system. First, we will see questions and accordingly I'll revise the concept also. Clear? So let's have the first question. It says, write 50,982 in figure. So first we will have our imaginary place value chart, which will be as ones, tens, hundred, thousand and 10,000. As it is 982, so I have placed 2 in ones place, 8 in tens place and 9 in hundreds place, that is 982, and we have 50,000. So 5 under 10,000s column and 0 under thousands column will give me the answer as 50,982. Don't forget to place comma before 3 digit. Okay, this is my answer. The next question is, write 107,507 in figures. See students, in this question you have 100 year, then 1000 and then 100 again. But in the first question you saw that it had 1000 and 100. Here in the first question they are placed in the descending order. That is 1000 is bigger and 100 is smaller. So they are placed in a particular descending order. But in the second question, we have 100, 1000, then again it is 100. So there is no particular order as such. So I will say that the second question is from the international place value system. So my imaginary place value chart will look like this. That is, the chart will be from international place value, and it would have ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000 and 100,000. You remember, no students, in international place value system we place zero, we place comma before 3 digit, okay? And because of that comma, we have the number divided into different periods. That is 1000 period and then ones period. Okay. So in my question, it is having 507. So I am placing 507 like this. And the second part of my question says 107,000. As it is 107,000, I place this 107,000 in the thousands period, as in 7 in thousands column and 1 under 100,000s column. Clear with it, student? So my answer would be appearing somewhat like this, with a comma before 3 digit. Okay? See, I have not placed a comma between 1 and 0. Why? Because this question is from international place value system, and in that we don't place comma before 2 digit. We place comma before every 3 digit. Okay. Let's move on to the next question. The next question is, what is the number which has 3 tens, 700, 8000, 4 10,000, 2 ones and 3 lakh? See, now I am having 3 lakh here. So automatically my mind will have an opinion that this question is from Hindu Arabic system. In Hindu Arabic system, our place value chart appear somewhat like this, that is ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000 and lakh. And in international place value system, instead of lakh, we have 100,000. Okay, so I will just put the numbers which I have. See, it's two ones, so two under ones column, then three tens, so three under tens column. It's 700, so 7 under hundreds column, 8,000, 8,000, 4 10,000, so 4 under 10,000s column, and it is 3 lakhs, so 3 under lakhs column. Clear? Now students, you must be remembering that in Hindu Arabic system, we place comma before 3 digit and then we place it before 2 digit, and hence we have different periods, which is known as ones period and thousands period, and then we have lakh period. Okay, so my answer would appear to be 3,48,732 with a comma before 3 digit and then before 2 digit. Okay, the next topic we saw was successor and predecessor. Let's have the question. It says form largest 5-digit number by using 1648 and state its successor and predecessor. Now see students, in this question you have only 4-digit, but you have been asked to make 5-digit largest number. So it is a must that you have to repeat any of the digit to make it a 5-digit number. Clear? As I have been asked largest 5-digit number, what I will do is, first of all, I'll place this 4-digit in the largest number form and it will turn up to be 8,641. But this can't be my answer because it is only 4-digit, but I have been asked to make it largest 5-digit. Okay, so what I'll repeat is, I'll repeat the largest number, that is 8. Okay, so my answer would turn out to be largest 5-digit number would be 88,641, and its successor would be one more than the number, that is the after number, that would be 88,642, and the predecessor would be, don't make the predecessor number of the successor, the number predecessor number would be of the largest 5-digit number. Don't make that mistake, students. It would be 88,640, which is one less than the number. Predecessor means the before number. Clear? The next topic we saw was rounding off of the number. Okay, let's have a question. State whether the statement is true or false. When 46,327 is rounded off to nearest 100, we get 46,300. Is it true or false? Let's see. So the number is 46,327 and it is to be rounded off to nearest 100. Okay, so as in the rounding off of the number, we have to find out the rounding of place and the number to its right. Okay, so 3 is the rounding off place because it is to be rounded off to nearest 100. I have bolded that 3. Okay, and the digit to its right is 2. Okay, what was the rule for rounding off? It said that the digit to the right of the rounding off place, that is 2, is 4 or less, we will keep the rounding off place as it is. So see vertically, like this way. 3 I am keeping as it is, I am not changing, because 2 is less than 4 or it is less than 5. Okay, so my answer is 46,300. So my answer would be true. Okay, the next question is, when 3085 is rounded off to nearest 10, we get 3080. So let's have a look. Is it true or false? The number is to be rounded off to nearest 10 and we have rounded out the rounding off place, that is 8. It is bold in letter. Okay, Now, the digit to its right, that is 5. If the digit to the right of the rounding off place is 5 or more, we add 1 to the rounding off place. So, see students, see it vertically. For 8, I have added 1 and I have turned it up to be 9. And then I have changed the rest of the digit as 0. Okay. So when 3085 is to be rounded to nearest 10, it turns up to be 3090. So here my answer would be false. Clear with it? In this example, we have rounded down, as in 327 to 300 only. Here we have rounded up, as in 85, you have turned up to be 90. Okay. Our next topic was Roman numerals. Roman numerals, you remember, they have a symbol of I for 1, they have V for 5 and X for 10. Okay, let's have the question. The question says write Roman numerals for 19. So first of all, I have to have an expanded form of 19, which would be 10 plus 9. And then representing 10 from the Roman numerals, we have X, and 9 we have IX. Combining them, I have this symbol, which is said to be 19 in Hindu Arabic system. Okay. The next question is write Hindu Arabic numbers for 3 times X and 3 times I. I will split them up first of all, and then I have the numbers for each symbol, that is, I have 10 for X and 1 for I, which would give me 30 plus 3, and then the answer would be 33. Okay. I hope it's clear to you, students. If students, you have any doubt, please feel free to ask in the school WhatsApp number, addressing it to Shraddha Waghani. Okay. Remember, students, we all teachers are always there to help you out.
I'm sure you must have completed the exercise from the first chapter and written in the notebook or somewhere on the paper. In the next video, we will start up with the second chapter. Till then, stay home, stay safe.